Hi everyone, this is Istara. I'm back. This is part two of the full moon for the message and twin flame card reading for the week of July 18th, 2016, and it is July 20th, 2016 that I'm doing this video. I apologize, our last one got cut off, but I didn't want to not post it out there because when I'm recording, the information comes in, and I can't guarantee that I would actually get the same information again, and I can't guarantee that it would come out as good as it did, or as flowing as it did. And so I am doing the second half of the video now, so it's the same reading, but this is the second half, part two. And I want to go back to the card for a minute because we got cut off. So if you look at this masculine card, the card representing the divine masculine. One thing I did not notice when I was looking at the card that I'm noticing now is he's like his face. He's kind of looking up a little bit, and it's almost like, I got it. Oh, yes, aha, like an aha moment. And I feel like that really represents the divine masculine, especially when we talk about what my guides had channeled earlier this week about the full moon energy of embodying our truth. It's like, aha. This is why things haven't worked out. This is why I've been stressed. This is why I'm not, you know, going in the right direction. I have to leave now, or I have to move now. So I feel like that really represents the divine masculine on this journey and on this path. So this resonates deeply for me as for the divine masculine. So now I'm going to turn the card over for the divine feminine. And, you know, it's funny. The card is perfect for the divine feminine, and I'll explain to you in just a moment. Let me show you what it looks like. The card is Snow White. If you can see that, there's a little bit of a glare, and I apologize. The lighting has changed. It's evening now. When I started my earlier video, it was definitely daylight coming through the window. Now it's evening. It took that long. So before I even say too much about it, I want you to know this is Snow White. So that represents you. It's not that you're sleeping and you're unaware and you're unawake. What I actually see it as is your masculine energies are coming in, your guides, if you will, your protectors are coming in to protect the divine feminine. And if you see way up here in the corner, there's like the witch from Snow White, and she's looking in and she's getting ready to pounce and to create havoc and wreak havoc in the divine feminine's world. So this is appropriate. I mean, after just a little while ago, I lost my connection. I literally, my computer just shut down and stopped working on me. So my camera shut down, everything did. And I apologize for the break again, but it shut down. And weird things like that have been happening. So one of the things that I've noticed recently, along with you know, the heaviness of the energy of the full moon, is that the darker energies, the darker beings, if you will, those that don't really want twin flames to come together, because we will change the very fabric of the planet. We will actually bring true, divine, unconditional love down into this reality in a way that the earth hasn't seen. And it will upset the apple cart, if you will. Ha ha, that's my little joke since we're talking about Snow White. It will upset everything because everybody's been so programmed to believe in what we're living now in this old paradigm of energy. And we're now in this like new energy of shifting and changing, but that's all due to the divine feminine embodying who she is. Now, as the awakened one, typically it is the divine feminine energy within the twin flame pair. And so the twin flame pair is the divine feminine. She's been going through her wake-up calls and her changes. And I'm saying her, but I don't necessarily mean the divine feminine is a she, because it very well could be a male. But in this, for the purpose of this, I'm saying she. She's been really becoming the creator, the changer, the bringing of new energy here. And because of that, she's been working really hard. And so I feel like for myself, particularly in the last couple of months, I felt like a shift of energy where it doesn't feel like I'm working as hard, and it doesn't feel like I am struggling as much. I guess that's more the right word. I wouldn't say working as hard, because I've been working. But I would say I'm not struggling as much. I'm able to maintain my balance much more. I'm able to maintain a connection with my twin even when we're not speaking. And that's been a little bit. We haven't spoken for a while at the moment. So I am able to maintain a balance and not get caught up in my thing that I call spiral of hell. So it's like you start feeling crappy and then just keep spiraling downward. And that's the old way of coping for me in the past, especially with regard to this particular situation with my twin. But the last couple months, I would say that I'm really not feeling that same energy. Instead, I'm feeling like I'm maintaining balance better. I'm staying grounded better, and I'm not having the struggle like I did as much. So for me, when I look at this card, that's what I feel this represents. This represents the feminine being able to take a break and resting a little bit, and also giving her permission to turn inward and work on some of her stuff that might be coming up. It's also letting her know that she has helpers. You know, you see these two little dwarfs over here in the card, and they're here to help. You know, they're here to protect us, and those are our guides, our workers that we don't see. Those are the invisible, unseen characters in our life that are always there to help us and assist us, and they're protecting us from the dark. And I like that this came up in the card, that it's more of a darker energy there, because what is happening is I really do think there's a lot of interference, and I believe there's a lot of interference because I believe a lot of twins are connecting and coming together now. And because of that, I feel like the dark energies are like, hey, no, you know, we like it the way it is. We don't want to change this. So I feel like we're in a transitional time, a very transformational period where one foot is in the future and one foot is in the past. And for the purpose of this, one foot is in the new paradigm and one is in the old paradigm. One is in the new patterning, the new creation, the new timelines, the new dimensions. The other one is in the old. So I feel like that's a huge deal about what is going on currently. And when you're having some of the old energies getting like uptight and worried, like, uh-oh, we're losing ground, we're losing footing, what do we do now? When that's happening, they get more active and they interfere more. And so if you see, she's sitting there in the window. She's not on top of Snow White. She's not bothering her. She's looking in the window. That is kind of how the dark operates, if you will. They stay in our field around us. They can't actually come into our field, but they can stay around us, influence our field, amplify whatever we're feeling. So when I was having, when I was talking just a few moments ago about the spiral of hell that I would go through, it's crazy when I think about it. And believe me, there's times that I feel like, uh-oh, I'm getting ready to spiral. I need to take myself quickly out of it. When I would go there, I would probably be sad about something. And then all of a sudden, everything around me would get compounded on top of it. And then the energy would be amplified. So I would feel everybody's feelings, but I would also feel mine being amplified like hundreds of times. And that's because the darker energies, if you will, that linger, hang around, they like that. They feed off of drama, they feed off of pain, they feed off of fear. So if they're enjoying that kind of energy, that's like their currency, if you will. If they're living off that and enjoying it, they're going to make sure you amplify and you have that and you carry that out and you go forward with that energy. So that's why clearing is so important. That's why grounding and anchoring is so important. And I encourage all of you to really get a routine where you're clearing and taking care of your energy every day. And as you do it for you, you do it for your twin as well. And the more you do that, the more you keep balance. And, you know, I have to tell you, I've been doing it for years. And I've been very consistent for the last year. And I notice when I start to slip a little bit by being too tired and choosing to do my meditations a little too late at night and I'm getting sleepy, that's when I feel like, uh-oh, they can creep in a little because I'm not fully present. So clearing is really, really important. It's really important to be present. And I feel like that's what this card is telling us and reminding us, that we might have a breather right now, but it's really important that we still maintain ourselves and maintain the dream. And I like the fact that the word dream came in because she's sleeping. So I just want to bring that up close again for you to see. And let's look at the overall perspective for the twin flame relationship that I'm seeing with this full moon. I love this card. It kind of goes with what we just already spoke about a few moments ago. Let me show that to you. It's the Two of Swords. You can see that. So to me, this card represents exactly what I just got through saying about staying in balance and staying in maintaining your wellness and your balance. So looking at this card a little bit more and talking more about the channel I did earlier with regard to the full moon energy from the Arcturian Masters of Light and the Galactic Federation. So what they were saying is that there's resistance happening. So I think this represents twin flame couples, but not so much the couple, but individuals within the couple. And so, for example, like the divine masculine, he might be resisting the changes. He might be feeling and hearing his soul truth. And he's like, I want to embody this. This is what I want. I know there's something more out there for me. I know I'm supposed to have something better. I know this is not how life is supposed to be. He may be thinking that and feeling that, but he's not necessarily jumping to do it. And it may not be because he doesn't want to. Again, the old beliefs, the old patterns, the old fears are coming up for him as well. So he's kind of in that internal struggle. So if you look at this as his perspective, that's what he's going through. He's going through that back and forth, like, I want it. No, I don't. Because that means I have to work and change. I really don't like what I have. I really want it. No, I really don't know if I want to change. So that, I feel like, really symbolizes what's happening in terms of him on the path. The divine masculine is definitely receiving the messages of change and transformation and coming out to be who he really is. Just allowing that to come up through him, embodying everything coming down. So my feeling is with him, he's really struggling to embody who he is fully. But his soul is going to keep calling to him, and his soul is going to make him present to the world his soul's truth, not his ego, not the perspective that he's been wanting to have, but his soul's truth. So that is really huge. Now, in terms of the female and the divine feminine energy, looking at this card, I feel like it also represents her perspective. So it's about her staying in balance, maintaining where she's at, clearing her energy, and allowing her to feel like she's actually achieving something. So I really strongly feel that this is all about what's happening about both of us, because even though the masculine may be struggling a little to embody his soul's truth, there's parts of us as a divine feminine, those of us who carry that vibration, we might be having trouble embodying who we fully are. And what I mean by that is old patterns may be surfacing for us to get rid of. We may think, oh, they're done, we're gone, we're finished with that. But the truth is, we're never really finished until we're really finished. And so little bits and pieces might come up that get in the way. And when you actually recognize that and you start to see it, then you will find that, oh, okay, well, that's what I need to work on. Oh, that's what I need to do. So learning to embrace fully who you are as well. And maybe that's speaking your truth about your twin flame, knowing that your twin flame does exist, knowing that this is a real journey for you, and not having to like say to people, to the naysayers, no, this is real. You don't have to keep doing that. Embodying who you are doesn't mean you have to keep defending who you are. It just means being who you are and not worrying about what other people may think or what other people might say. So I feel like this is really representative of both the twins. And when I look at it as a perspective of the couple itself, I feel like it's the masculine and the feminine battling each other's energy in the sense of, well, I want to do it this way. No, I want to do it that way. And I feel like on a higher dimension, we're coming together to figure out what is going to be the balance for us to actually come together. Because right now we've been so in like frenetic energy over the last year, particularly last 6 months because of all the activations happening. And so when I look at this card for the perspective of the unions in general, when I look at that, it's all about finding balance. I feel like they're balancing themselves on the rocks, but they're coming together and there's like conflicting ideas and conflicting thoughts. And so I want to say a couple more words about that particularly. So when we are coming together and we have expectations and beliefs about how we see our twin union coming together, what it should look like, how it should be, what we think based on our human living experiences and our human experiences with relationships. We've seen it. We see the fairy tales. We see the, people on TV, actually social media, because I don't really have TV, but social media, you know, this is my happy family. And we don't really know their story. And they may present as this happy family. They may be, they may not be. But the thing is, we're not doing it the way they've done it. We're doing it through the twin flame way, which is completely different love relationship. It's completely different in the aspect that the divine love between twin flames never disappears, never goes away. And they might physically walk away from us, but they are still here always. And our connection is divine and unconditional. Whereas when you're in a traditional soulmate relationship, it's not conditional. It's not unconditional. It's very conditional. And you'll recognize that by how you treat each other. And so a lot of times we'll try to attribute those qualities to what you're doing with your twin flame. And then we get into trouble because we have all these expectations. So I feel like that's a huge deal about us getting balance within us and our expectations about them. You know, my expectation is that I email my twin. Whether he responds or not is another story. It's totally fine if he doesn't. I don't expect him to. If he does, woohoo, I'm so happy. But if he doesn't, it doesn't like tear me apart anymore. It actually gives me the ability to just speak my truth to him in email and say, I love you, or I feel this way, or I'm thinking of you. And I'm not thinking, should I send him this or should I not send it to him? I just do. And I feel like that's where we're all trying to get to that balance of just being who we are. And I'm one of those people who likes to send emails. I'm mushy. I'm a romantic. And my twin is too. However, he doesn't always show that to me through email, through words on paper. He usually shows it through his words on a phone, speaking to me in person, or actions. But I want to say that be who you are. Embody that fully. So that's what I want to tell you about the Divine Feminine and about the perspective for the week. And I want to mention one last thing. So last videos, I had mentioned that I saw dragonflies like all over the place. Well, since that video of last week, I think I did it on the 12th. I can't recall. I'm sorry. Numbers and days just kind of disappear for me. I have seen dragonflies every single day that I have left my house. And every time I've been outside, they've been around me. So I am like, wow. Big changes are coming. Major things are coming. I see tremendous things happening over the next several months. And I'm hoping it's the reunion of all of us. I'm hoping that each of us finds that connection and is able to kind of raise our vibrations quickly up into the higher realms to actually experience that divine love. And I feel like major things are coming. So pay attention out there, see what's happening, and pay attention to what's going on inside of you, because the same soul voice will repeat over and over to you in many different ways, many different colors, many different languages, how it wants you to be you, how it's presenting to the world, and what the goals are for you. So listen to your soul. It always knows its truth, and it will always bring it back to you. You will never be far off of that. The only time you're off the path is when you don't listen. And, you know, the truth is you're never really off the path, even if you're not listening. It's just that they'll try to get louder for you. And you'll know because they'll make it louder and it'll come in different ways. And my last words of wisdom, again, from the other video, trust. Just have faith, hope, and love that all will be exactly what you wish it to be in this life. Hold into that energy and not what you're afraid of. And if fears are coming up, please don't jump into the spiral of hell. instead, look at the fear. Embrace it for a moment and say, yeah, that's pretty scary. And that really freaks me out because what if that doesn't happen? Feel that for a moment and then let it go. Because the longer you hold on to it, the more it's going to affect you. And if you don't address it at all, you can't heal. We have to feel to heal. And so all this stuff will surface for us to feel and experience, and then we can release it and then actually have a real healing. And I'm going to stop rambling for now. I wish you all well. I wish you magical blessings on your way to a happy union. And I send love and light to all of you. Namaste.